Breasts and Eggs by Miyako Kawakami. Book summary. Book 1 is set back in the summer of 2008, with the reader following Natsuko Natsume, a struggling young writer living in Tokyo, as she heads off to the station to meet her sister, Makiko, and her niece, Midoriko. The two have come up for a short trip from Natsuko's hometown of Osaka, and the entire story takes place over the few days the visitors spend as her guests. However, what you'd think would be a happy family reunion is slightly tenser than expected. For one thing, the 12-year-old Midoriko isn't speaking with her mother, insisting on communicating at all times via messages scrawled in a notebook, which makes the hours spent in Natsuko's sweltering apartment slightly awkward. And there's the reason for Makiko's visit, one of the causes of Midoriko's withdrawal. Having reached the age of 39, Makiko has decided that it's time for a change, and a fairly radical one at that. The trip to see her sister in Tokyo is actually an excuse to find out more about getting breast implants. This first part of Breasts and Eggs is a fascinating story, with Kawakami alternating the scenes in the cramped apartment with visits to restaurants and bathhouses, extracts from Midoriko's journal, and memories of the two sisters' childhoods back in Osaka. It's a story centered entirely upon women, with very little room for, or mention of, men, and Natsuko, who has a fairly quiet, secluded existence in the capital, is dragged back into a life she thought she'd left behind. Much of the backstory looks at the poverty the sisters grew up in, the two girls living in a tiny apartment with few windows, hearing fights in the street at night, or simply drunk and singing. Their hometown is certainly an interesting place. Aside from the people coming in and out or simply walking by, you'll find people slumped down motionless under the payphones, women who looked well into their 60s promising dances for 2,000 yen, and no shortage of vagrants and drunks. But you'll also find the whole of Osaka Shabashi comes alive at night from appearances. It's a dump end from sundown to sunup. On the third floor of a building throbbing with karaoke reverb, you'll find the bar where Makiko works, 5 nights a week, from 7 until midnight. The sisters grew up poor, having to work hard to survive, particularly after the death of their mother and grandmother. But while Natsuko found a way out, Makiko stayed in this world, spending her nights in a rundown hostess club to make ends meet. Yet as Makiko fights her way through life, she doesn't realize that her daughter is different, and is starting to buckle under the strains of growing up. The other day at school, between classes, I forget who, but someone was saying, "I was born a girl, so yeah, I definitely want to have a baby of my own eventually." Where does that come from, though? Does blood coming out of your body make you a woman, a potential mother? What makes that so great anyway? Does anyone really believe that? Just because they make us read these stupid books doesn't make it true. I hate it so much. Left double quotation mark. Having seen how her mother's life has panned out, Midoriko is afraid of taking the same path and is dreading the arrival of her first period, and the journey towards adulthood it entails. Unsurprisingly, then, Makiko's constant talk of breasts is the last thing she needs, and it's going to take a lot more than a few scribbled notes to mend the relationship with her mother. This trepidation regarding becoming a woman is placed beside some slightly more graphic details regarding the issues women face in society. When Natsuko and her visitors spend time at the apartment, the television is often on in the background, and the stories covered in the news programs tend to be rather disturbing. On several occasions, the trio hear of crimes committed against other women, with the poor victims sexually assaulted and even butchered, then dumped like rubbish. In this way, what starts out as a slightly messy, Disjointed tale of an awkward family reunion becomes an examination of what women can expect from society, and as Kawakami shows us, it isn't always pretty. By the end of this day, she and her family have become much closer, with each of them ready to carry on, whatever the next stage of life might throw at them.